Today in History. Okay, this is the very first day in history this week, and I wonder what interesting thing happened on this day.
Well, we're going to find out about two events in just a moment, but first here is today's quiz question. One of Australia's most renowned buildings is the Sydney number one steakhouse or number two opera house. All right, once again, one of Australia's most renowned buildings is the Sydney number one steakhouse or number two opera house. If you know the answer, you can put it on our Bundy board or text in on your cell phone, pounder sharp 1045. That will cost you 51 to win a wireless mouse.
All right, now let's go and check out what interesting or significant event happened on this day in the past.
Today in history. In 1965, the Beatles' Yesterday received a gold record, and in 1973, the Sydney Opera House was opened.
1965년 10월 20일, 자, 비틀스의 Yesterday 이 노래가 골드 레코드를 수상한 날이고요. 1973년 10월 20일, 시드니에 있는 오페라 하우스가 개관한 날입니다.
Well, today we take a look back at two of the most renowned icons of the 20th century.
Right, and we're going to begin with a song presumably performed over 7 million times
wow.
in the 20th century alone, and which received a gold record on this day in 1965.
And we're talking about a staple tune from the Fab Four, which needs no better introduction than its trademark tune and lyrics. Here's a clip.
Suddenly, I'm not half the man I used to be. There's a shadow hanging over me. Oh, yesterday came suddenly.
Yesterday was reportedly composed by Paul McCartney in one night.
Mm-hmm.
And it was originally titled Scrambled Eggs.
I think Yesterday is a better title than Scrambled Eggs, right?
Scrambled Eggs.
Yeah. Luckily, it was renamed Yesterday. I think we can agree. And according to McCartney, John Lennon actually came up with the title.
Mm-hmm. And Yesterday is, according to the Guinness Book of World Record, one of the most recorded songs in the history of modern music, with at least 1,600 cover versions as of 1986.
As of 1986, so a lot more now,
I know,
right?
Which was, what, 20 years ago?
Yes, exactly. Almost 30
more
now.
Than almost 30.
Yeah. All right, now let's talk about another icon, this time an architectural structure.
That's right, and that's none other than Australia's Sydney Opera House, which opened on this day in 1973.
Yes, indeed. With at least a million people visiting the venue every year, it is one of the busiest arts performing centers in the world.
Uh-huh. And it was designated as a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 2007, and it has been widely deemed as one of the most distinctive buildings of the 20th century.
As for the genius mind that came up with such a masterpiece, he was Danish architect Jørn Utzon, who received a Pritzker Architecture Prize, architecture's highest honor, in 2003.
Uh-huh. Okay, so much about the Opera House.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I had a chance to walk right by that building.
Okay.
And to be honest, okay, this is it. It was during the daytime, of
yeah.
course. And then I'm sure it looks magnificent
at night. Yeah, everything always looks prettier at night, doesn't
right,
it?
Right, I think
yeah.
so. Yeah. This is a wonderful architectural
right.
construction there.
Okay, so before we finish up the answer to the quiz question, one of Australia's most renowned buildings is the Sydney number one steakhouse, number two opera house, and the answer is number two, an opera house.
That's right.
That's it for today in history, and we'll be back tomorrow with more from the past.